What I'm going to show you are the different areas of the neck that are going to be associated with different kinds of head pain. And that can be headaches, migraines, different things like that. Hi, I'm Dr. Jeffrey Hanna from Atlas Health Australia. And what we do is we look after the upper part of the neck as far as how it relates to head, brain, and overall body function. So, point is, there's lots and lots of different kinds of head pain that people will experience. And I want to point out, using this little model here, where some of these things will oftentimes originate from. Because, well, based on the research, huge amounts of headache, migraine, neck pain issues, they're not chemical and they're not even caused by stress. They're caused by some kind of mechanical or physical problem in the neck that your body just can't quite fix on its own. And if that happens, well, what it can do is it can start to produce swelling, pressure, irritation to some of the nerves right up through here, which is going to start to radiate and go into different places in your head, in your neck, etc., etc. So, just to give you a little bit of an orientation of what we're looking at here, this is a giant size model of the head, the C1 or the atlas vertebra, and then the C2. This is going to be it from the front side. I will turn it this way so that now we're looking at it from the back. And you'll kind of be able to know a few of these spots on your own. So, for example, if you were to feel that little bony spot right behind your ear, we're talking about this spot. So, right by the atlas there. And if you go in the midline on the back of the neck, you'll feel a bump right up at the top. That's normal, and that is the tip of the C2 vertebrae, like this. So, what I want to show you is going to be this. So, we've got this little space located right here. It's going to be between the back of your skull and between the C1. This is going to be where the C1 nerve comes from. And the C1 nerve is oftentimes responsible for the sensory portion of what people describe as their sinuses, or in other words, that area right between there and, quote, behind the eyes. So oftentimes, if people say, "Oh, I've got this kind of an issue right there," I'm going to wonder if something like that is going on. Next one is the C2 nerve, and that's going to come out between the C1 and the C2 in this spot right here. Whichever, excuse me, if it ever gets swollen, you know it because it's this thumping kind of pain in the back of the head right about there. And the C2 nerve goes to all kinds of different places. It's going to run up the back of the head like this and can produce issues like that. It is going to run along the side of the neck, producing issues like that. And what it's also going to do is it's going to go right up to the very back of the skull. So sometimes people are diagnosed with a condition known as suboccipital neuralgia, this burning pain just across the base of the skull. C2 is often involved. The C3, which can be down here just a little bit lower, that one is also very often involved. But I want to come back to this C2 just a little bit more because there's a little bit more to the story that I want to share with you. Number one, it's not so much what's going on the outside, but it's what's going on the inside. At the level of the C2, because the C2 is the thing that allows you to turn your head like this, the part of the brain stem that's responsible for processing all of the information about your head, face, and about your jaw is located in that spot right there. And so, if we have distortions where something has gotten turned and locked out of position, it's oftentimes associated with jaw pain, temple pain, and a condition known as trigeminal neuralgia, pain or stabbing pain that's going on in the face. Not a nice thing. And I'm going to add one more, just going back one higher level, up to the level of the C1. And the C1 is going to be around an area which is called, the fancy term is the nucleus tractus solitarius. What in the world is that? It's the processing center from what's called your vagus nerve. And the vagus nerve is what's controlling all of your internal organs, things like that. But it also has a really important branch, something called a recurrent meningeal nerve. And what that is that's going to be detecting the sensory information from the inside of the skull, the connective tissue around the brain. And irritation of that particular nerve at that particular level in the neck can oftentimes be associated with a migraine. And so that pulling, tearing, that inside pressure of the head, that is one of the most important things to look at. And certainly, if you do have different things in your diet, stress, and all that, your body's going to tighten up like this, and so those symptoms are going to get worse. But what I wanted to show you is I wanted to show you where these actual nerve pathways are in the head, in the brain, in the neck, so that you know, okay, well, if these things have a physical cause, Very likely, then, it's a physical solution that's necessary for you to find the relief that you are ultimately looking for. A little bit of a longer video, but I hope this may offer a little bit more insight as far as the different kinds of things that can go on in the neck and the kind of things that we are looking at to find out what in particular do you or do you perhaps have going on, and how is this related to the different kinds of head or neck pain that you might be experiencing. So if you've been dealing with something for any length of time, head pain, neck pain, something like that, I'd encourage you, take the next step. Feel free to contact us, give us an email, something like that, and share and post this, or share and then post stuff on this video, just to let us know how can we help you. Because anything that we're able to do, any information we're able to provide, we're absolutely happy to do that. This is Dr. Jeffrey Hanna at Atlas Health Australia, the Brain and Body Connection.